What are you doing?
I'm the co-host.
Get out. Vamonos. Scram. Vamos. Get out. You're an unpaid intern. Co-host. Psh, I ride solo. Hello and welcome back to the Teddy Cruz Show. I'm your host, Teddy Cruz. We've taken a one-year intermission and now we're back with the best show on cable television, the Teddy Cruz Show. I'm here with a local film editor, Jeru, who recently directed a movie, as I hear. Mind filling me in on that?
Yeah. We actually directed a horror movie called Checkmate, which is pretty popular, actually.
Yeesh, giving me the chills here. Mind filling me in on this thriller movie here?
So, the Checkmate was actually directed by me, and I also acted in it as the main actor, which was really cool and fun.
Fun. Sounds fun. Mind filling me in on kind of the premise of the story? Don't spoil anything, but just the gist of it?
It's about this guy, the main character, which is me. Yeah, I know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty awesome, but I mean, you're awesome, too.
We're both awesome. Yeah. We got this.
Yeah. But it's about this main character who loses his sister over a game of chess. I can't fill you in totally on it, but...
Oh, yeah, that...
You'd have to see that.
Oof, so. I'm getting the chills just thinking about it. Well, we're actually going to watch your movie right now, so let's go!
Hello, I'm Adam. I'm from PII. We were very interested in your story. Thank you for sharing, by the way. Do you care to start from the beginning? Just tell us when this all started.
Sure. It all started in my living room just yesterday. It's a total shock to me.
I understand.
It all started with that chessboard.
Oh, God!
Look what I found.
Really? A chessboard?
Yeah, well, I found it while I was cleaning. Wanna play?
I'd rather not. It's pretty creepy. It's creepy.
What? Are you afraid of losing?
No. Why would I be afraid of losing?
Then let's play.
Okay. Right, you go first.
Fine.
Yeah, that's not normal. I think you should check that out. Okay.
Yeah.
There can only be one. Finish the game. Now.
Let's do it. And just like that, we wanted to check it out.
All right. I think I'm getting the gist of what you're saying here. We pulled some old files, found out that there was an old man, he was living in your house before you, very competitive chess player, best in state. No name, no real identity whatsoever, we couldn't get that.
That actually makes sense though. We heard some voices.
Sir moved you.
Queen me. Checkmate.
You win. What happens now?
Congratulations, winner. You are free to go. Loser stays.
And that was it.
All right, that's pretty much all we needed, so thanks for sharing again.
You think you can help me?
Son, I really doubt it. But don't worry, your sister, she won't be forgotten. She will definitely be remembered, and we will make sure to tell your story.
Okay.
introduce.
Hello.
What are you doing here?
I'm co-hosting.
Get out.
But.
Hey.
But.
We
can
talked
I just
about
do
this.
One interview?
I am a just solo writer. You shall not disturb.
But, please.
Leave me. Interns.
I'm right.
Rule number one, you never disturb the host while they're doing their show. Anyway, hello, welcome back. I'm Teddy Cruz, and this is the Teddy Cruz Show. I'm here with Ben Saunders, who is a local film director in the area. Ben, how's it going?
It's going pretty great. I feel good being here.
I feel great having you. So, I hear you recently directed a movie. Mind filling me in?
Our team was looking for a new project to shoot, and we're thinking, you haven't done a comedy yet. Comedies are fun. They're fun to watch. You get a laugh. It's great. And so we were trying to brainstorm ideas that would be simple and not too hard to do. And one enlightened being decided that, isn't it funny how words just die overnight?
Yeah.
Just randomly. One day you're saying, oh, YOLO. The next day you're saying, oh, bae. And then the next day, who knows what we're saying?
Welcome to the English language, where words can literally die overnight.
Just dead.
Well, we're going to split some ribs, have some laughs, and watch your comedy right now. In that case, let's go!
YOLO! YOLO! YOLO!
Dude, YOLO's dead.
Gotta get ready for my journey to find the meaning of life. Let's see. Good old-fashioned read material in case I get bored on my trip.
Been working out.
Looking good, bro.
Hey guys, can you guys like help me out? I'm trying to find the meaning of life.
I think you need to find like the wise master or something like that.
Yeah, man.
Can you guys like, you guys got know by chance where he'd be?
I don't know, bro. Go check with the hipsters down in Hipster Village.
Alright, thanks guys. Hey man, what's up?
What's up, man?
Can you help me out? I'm trying to find the meaning of life.
The meaning of life?
Yeah.
Do you think I know?
Yeah, yeah.
Do I look smart?
Yeah.
These aren't real, man. This isn't real. Get out of here, man.
All right.
Go to the nerds or something.
All right, man. I'll see you later.
Go.
Hey, man. What's up?
Oh. Hi.
Do you think you could help me out? I'm trying to find the meaning of life.
Oh, you're looking for that old master, aren't you?
Yeah. If that's who I gotta talk to, for sure.
Well, here. What has a mouth but does not eat?
No clue.
Gotta guess. It's a riddle.
I don't know.
A river! Just go find the river.
Okay. Thanks, man. What the heck? Hey, Grandmaster, where you at, though? Whoa! Who are you?
I'm the Grandmaster.
But you're a girl.
What are you? A sexist?
No. I didn't... Whatever. Anyway, I was told I had to talk to you to find the meaning of life, something like that. Do you think you can help me out?
Oh, okay. I got this. 25% off of Macy's this weekend.
What the heck does that have to do with my life?
Dude! I can't tell you the meaning of life. You have to figure it out yourself. All I found was from Google.
Oh, well, okay then. So, wait, are we just going to go through, like, training? Or are we going to go... Well, what's the deal here? What do we...
Yes, we will be doing some training. 1,000 more push-ups! You can do this, man! More!
Eggnog flavored skim milk. 1530.0460.
Nope. This page.
You know what? I don't got time for this. I'm gonna be late for lunch. Thanks for all your help, but I can't even do this.
cat.
Bay!
Hey, guy, where's Bay at? Hey, have you seen Bay? Hey, dude, where's Bay at?
That was so last year, dude.
Welcome back to the Teddy Cruz Show, and I'm here with my next guest. Wait, what are you doing here?
I'm here to interview you.
About what?
About the gaming documentary, Games for Thought.
Oh, you mean my spectacular piece of art of a documentary. Yes, I suppose that would be fair to interview me about my masterpiece. Anyway, carry on, ask me your questions.
Alrighty then. Tell us more about the documentary.
This documentary is designed to enlighten people on what it is gamers really are. We're not just those creepy people who sit in their basements and play their cards and their Xbox or PC or whatever you play. We're actually good people who know what we're doing, and generally, we're not all that creepy. I'm not that creepy, and I'm a gamer. I mean, look at me. I'm awesome. Anyway, I was trying to bring a general awareness to the public to say, hey, you stop your stereotyping and your bad jokes. We're good people and you know it. Anyway, any more questions?
Yes, I have a few. What do you think is going to appeal more to the audience about this documentary?
I would say that it would probably be younger gamers, because older gamers, like, for example, the people who play for tournaments such as League of Legends, they're higher up, they're more respected, ooh, everybody loves them. But the younger gamers who are just getting started, the people who are, you know, the people that play Call of Duty, Halo, Hearthstone, things like that, they don't get enough recognition. And I feel like this documentary will tell them, hey, it's okay to be a gamer. I'm not a complete loser. I'm not even a loser. I'm actually awesome. Anyway, carry on.
That's a really good point there. My brother plays Call of Duty, and he isn't the best gamer. So, you said that you were a very intense gamer back
Definitely.
Then. Do you consider yourself an intense gamer now?
For sure. Intense. I consider myself to be an awesome intense gamer. That's like a whole nother level.
Like, from awesome intense gamer to PewDiePie gamer?
I'd put myself right in the middle between the two. Would be awesome, legendary, fantastic gamer.
Good. Cool. Yeah, that is all the questions that I have for you about Games for Thought.
All right. I'll sign us off. I'm Teddy Cruz, and...
And I'm Sylvia, his co-host.
You are a paid intern. You are to never say that again. Ever. We're going to watch my awesome documentary right now, so let's go.
Well, I find gaming to be a very powerful aspect in our culture. Lots of young adults actually play gaming, not surprisingly, and even younger than...
I think it's affecting our culture because of how new it is, but I guess it's most video games that we know of, like Super Mario's and Sonic, was for like from really old times, like in the 80s and 90s.
The core of the gamer community is probably that stereotyped people who are like 16 to 23, and they do a lot of that gaming. They'll do other things, of course, but I mean, like, that's usually, I think, like, the biggest age range for gamers, and then also mostly guys. No offense, but I mean, I think we hear a lot more about gamer guys than gamer girls.
Yeah, sure. I think it's actually open to everyone. I think you could join if you wanted to, even if you didn't play video games, and it's pretty accepting.
We end up stereotyping gamers as, you know, those males, the guys that are 16 to 23-ish, all have those beards, and they sit and they play their games, or they play their card games or their board games, and that's all they ever do, which isn't that true. I mean, I'm a gamer. I don't got a beard yet. Well, I guess I am 16. But what I'm saying is that there's a lot more people in that gaming community that don't fit that stereotype.
I guess it's because of YouTube, because most of the YouTube gamers, you know, like PewDiePie, Markiplier, they are seen as middle-aged men with beards. And, you know, it kind of, you can kind of see it's being stereotyped because, you know, it's grown men actually playing some kid games, which is kind of weird.
Well, gaming tournaments, they try to be open to everybody, but people might think, oh, I'm not good enough to try that. Oh, I don't think that I'm much of a gamer. I don't think I'd be good in a tournament. So I think it's kind of like that looming scariness of like, oh, I don't want to try this because it's new and it might be hard and I might lose and then I might cry and things like that. I mean, I feel like it's not as bad as people think, but they don't quite market and try to get people into those tournaments, which I think might help.
I like gaming because I'm subscribed to most of the gamers on YouTube. And I like playing games with my brother.
To me, gaming is like my, I won't say escape, but it is my way of doing something that I love with my friends. Due to physical reasons, I'm not really able to play things like soccer, football, basketball, and all the sports that all my friends can do. But when I discovered that games like Magic the Gathering, and other games like that they were competitive as well, it kind of gave me a way to express creativity while still doing something I love. Why do I game? I game for many reasons. The biggest ones right now, actually, I'm trying to kind of prove something more. To me, it's kind of proving something because I'm always used to people saying that I wouldn't really amount to much, but that I'd be able to do something. And to me, gaming is kind of my way of saying, this is what I do, I'm good at it, I like it, and I'm actually enjoying doing this. We've had a heck of a night here telling you all about local films and the people that make them. We hope you enjoyed our little bit and that you'll come back for more. My name is Teddy Cruz and this has been The Teddy Cruz Show. But wait, don't get up. Check out these sick moves.